إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. Every going astray and every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدِ. My dear brothers in Islam, the month of Hajj has elapsed us. And now we have reached the blessed and sacred month of Al-Muharram, which Allah has specially chosen. And we praise and we thank Allah for the blessings that we see and we don't see, the blessings that we acknowledge and we don't acknowledge. وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. And if you, Allah said what means, and if you were to count the favors and the blessings of Allah, you would never be able to count them all or to enumerate them. Allah gave us another blessing, especially bringing us to reach special and virtuous times and occasions like this blessed month of Al-Muharram, one of the sacred months. So fear Allah, ya ibadallah, and thank Him and glorify Him. Muharram is one of those months in which Allah made them sacred and has made fighting in them forbidden. قال الله إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا في كتاب الله يوم خلق السماوات والأرض منها أربعة حرم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in Surah At-Tawbah what means, verily the number of months with Allah is 12 months in a year. So was it ordained by Allah on the day when He created the heavens and the earth. Of them, four are sacred. And we know from the authentic hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ثَلَاثَةٌ مُتَوَالِيَاتٌ ذُو الْقِعْدَةِ وَذُو الْحِجَّةِ وَالْمُحَرَّمِ وَرَجُبٌ مُدَرَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ جُمَادَةٍ وَشَعْبَانٍ. These months that are sacred are four in the year. ذُو الْقِعْدَةِ ذُو الْحِجَّةِ, this month of Al-Muharram, and also Rajab, which is between Jumad al-Thani and Sha'ban. So these months Allah made for fighting forbidden in them, in order that those who performed Hajj and Umrah can do and travel their journeys in a safe way. عن عائشة رضي الله عنها, she mentioned Ashura, the 10th of Muharram, the 10th of this blessed month, which coincides with tomorrow, inshallah, Saturday the 29th. It was a day on which the tribe of Quraysh, they used to fast in Jahiliyyah. The Prophet ﷺ, he also fasted on that day. فَلَمَّا قَدَمَ الْمَدِينَةِ صَامَهُ وَأَمَرَ بِصِيَامِهِ فَلَمَّا نَزَلَ رَمَضَانِ كَانَ مَنْ شَاءَ صَامَهُ وَمَنْ شَاءَ لَا يَصُومُهُ رَوَاهُ الْبُخَارِي. The Prophet ﷺ, it was said regarding him that when he migrated to Medina, he fasted on that day. And he ordered the Muslims to fast on that day. So when the fasting of Ramadan was enjoined, it became an optional fast for the people to do. Abu Huraira, he narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, أفضل الصيام بعد صيام شهر رمضان شهر الله المحرم. رواه الترمذي. This hadith, which is sahih in the Sunan of at-Tirmidhi, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us again the virtues of this blessed sacred month that we see here. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he referred to شهر الله المحرم, the month of Allah, Al-Muharram. The most virtuous of fasting after the fasting of Ramadan is the fasting done in this month of Al-Muharram. So it's desired to increase in good deeds in these sacred months and to increase in fasting in these sacred months, especially this month of Al-Muharram. And it is the month that the companions during Umar's time, radiallahu anhu, chose to begin the Hijri calendar with the month of Al-Muharram. Note here that Allah called it His month. This month we're in, Allah called it because the sunnah, the hadith, their wahi, their revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sunnah of this is refers to this month as Shahrullah al-Muharram. This is the month of Allah. So virtuous days, Let us increase in good and avoid disobedience and sin. The virtues of this month increases. Amongst it is the great virtue of its great virtues is the day of Ashura. It is found in it on the 10th day. It is the day when the Prophet ﷺ, he selected to perform fasting. And the day that Musa ﷺ fasted to thank Allah from freeing the children of Israel from Pharaoh, from Fir'aun. And after the death of Musa ﷺ, the Jews used to fast this day of Ashura. It was narrated on Ibn Abbas and radiallahu anhuma, that Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, he said that the Prophet ﷺ, he came to Al-Medina and he found the Jews fasting on this day. فَقَالَ مَا هَذَا He asked them, what is this? قَالُوا هَذَا يَوْمٌ أَنْجَى اللَّهُ فِيهِ مُوسَى وَأَغْرَكَ فِيهِ فِرْعَونَ فَصَامَهُ مُوسَى شُكْرًا They said, this is the day, Ashura, that Allah freed, he saved Musa alayhi salam and Bani Israel, the children of Israel, from Fir'aun. And he drowned Fir'aun. He drowned him in the Red Sea. So Musa alayhi salam, he fasted that day in gratitude. فَقَالَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ نَحْنُ أَحَقُّ بِمُوسَى مِنْكُمْ In another narration, وَأَوْلَى The Prophet alayhi salam, he said, we have more of a right to Musa alayhi salam, to Prophet Moses alayhi salam. In another narration, we are more first to him than you are. So he said, فَصَامَهُ وَأَمَرَ بِصِيَامِهِ So we are going to fast it, and he commanded the people to fast it. Similarly, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stated that if he lived till the next year, just to be different from those who are not Muslim, to be different than the mushrikeen and the Yahud and the Nasara, he said, I would fast the ninth along with it. قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لَإِنْ بَقِيتُ إِلَىٰ قَابِنٍ لَأَصُومَنَّ الْيَوْمَ التَّاسِعِ This hadith, which is authentic, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, if I live till next year, I will fast the ninth day along with the tenth, so that I can just be different from what the Yahud are, from what the Jews are doing in their practice of honoring that day. My brothers and sisters in Islam, therefore the ruling is to fast Ashura. This is a sunnah mu'akkada. There's no sin if you don't do it. But if you choose to do it, the best was to have fasted today and tomorrow with it. If you do not do so, then you can fast tomorrow, Saturday the 29th and Sunday the 30th. This would be the 10th and 11th of Muharram. And you have still differed. If you cannot do any and you just fast the 10th, then according to Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, this is okay. And inshallah, you will be rewarded for it. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنِّي أَحْتَسَبْ أَنْ يُكَفْرَ السَّنَةَ الْمَاضِيَةَ The Prophet ﷺ, he said, by fasting Ashura, I hope that Allah will forgive the previous sins of afwan of the previous year. Of course, this is the minor sins. You need to make tawbah for the major sins. أَقُولُ قَالِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرَ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ أَدْعُ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد My brothers in Islam عباد الله O servants of Allah The way of the Anbiya and their followers is that they thank Allah whenever Allah gives them victory and the way we thank Allah is through obedience and remembrance of Allah However we do not innovate And we do not bring into practice something which did not come from Allah and His messenger, from Allah or His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or the companions radiallahu anhum wa ardahum. We do not innovate anything in this affair, from jahiliyyah or from after those times. What the people do to bring innovations. وَإِنَّ شَرُّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا The worst of affairs are those things we introduce into this religion of ours. وَكُلُّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ And everything we introduce into this religion of ours, even if you think it's good, even if the people think they benefit from it, it is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ And every bid'ah, every innovation is misguidance. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ Every misguidance is in the hellfire. So we should not exceed the limits. As for what we see the Shia do on this day of Ashura, they make it a day of sadness, a day of wailing, a day of beating themselves, a day of weeping, because it's the day that Al-Husayn radiallahu anhu was murdered. Indeed, calamity is not to be faced by ignorance, nor is it to be faced by wailing sin and evil deeds. Rather, it should be faced with obedience to Allah and hoping for His reward. There is no doubt that the killing of Al-Husayn radiallahu anhu was a calamity, but Allah commanded us to exercise patience and hope for his reward during calamities. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقَسٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said what means, and surely we are going to try you, we're going to test you with fear and test you with loss of fruits and hunger and wealth and loss of loved ones, people you love, but give glad tidings to the patient ones, those who when Allah tests them and strikes them with a calamity or a trial, they say, "Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un." They say, "Indeed, to Allah we belong and to Him we will return." These are the ones who have the blessings from their Lord, and they will receive Allah's mercy, and these are the ones who are rightly guided. There is no doubt, again, that the killing of Al-Husayn radiallahu anhu was a calamity, but Allah commanded us to be patient. What is legislated on this day is that we fast, and there should be no newly invented matters. Nothing else. It's not a day to buy new clothes or to make sweets or to make special foods. It's a day to fast, to thank Allah for blessing us with guidance to this deen, to thank Allah for freeing Musa alayhi salam and the Muslims of Bani Israel, because they were the ones who followed by Allah's permission. They were Muslim. Therefore, it's obligated upon the Muslims to follow the sunnah and abandon the innovations in the deen, the innovations in the religion. We do not oppose them with more innovation or more sin or disobedience. We oppose them by abandoning them and reviving the sunnah. مَنْ سَنَّ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ سُنَّةٌ حَسَنَةٌ فَلَهُ أَجْرُهَا وَأَجْرُ مَنْ عَمِلَ بِهَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. The Prophet ﷺ said, whoever revives a sunnah, not makes a new one, whoever brings back a sunnah that people don't do or don't follow or have forgotten about, they will get the reward of all those who follow them in it without decreasing from those people's reward. Their whole time, the ones they do it, the ones, the deeds that they do that you brought back as the sunnah, they will get the reward of those. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who get this reward. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka anta sami'un qareebun mujibu ad-da'wat. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.